Hello guys, Russia is lying again. And I know it's nothing new because Russia is lying about everything and everywhere possible, but still, it is extremely important to debunk their fake narratives because they want to reshape our opinion. Right now, Russia pretends that everything is fine with its economy and sanctions are not working, when in reality it's just the country. And I'm really happy that the ministers of finance of 8 EU countries decided to express their professional opinions and to demonstrate why we cannot believe Russian description of its own economy, and in reality it is super overheated and now resembles Soviet more than ever before. So let me tell you more about these important conclusions of super professionals about the Russian economy that is about to collapse, hopefully together with the country. My name is Anna, I'm from Ukraine, I'm in Ukraine, I love my country, and I'm always glad to tell you more about our strengths and resilience in these challenging times. If you're new to the channel and you want to see Russia defeated, join and subscribe. So, I was really glad to read that 8 ministers of 8 EU countries and ministers of finance decided to address global public and explain why we cannot believe Russian fakes that everything is fine, sanctions do not work. They want to influence people, to influence businesses, and to make others think about lifting the sanctions if they are not working, when in reality they are working really well. So these ministers who expressed their opinion, and you can actually read more in The Guardian, I will link this article in the description of the video. So ministers of finance of Sweden, Denmark, Latvia, Lithuania, Estonia, the Netherlands, Poland and Finland expressed their professional opinion and demonstrated what things actually prove that Russian economy is in great trouble, in great turbulence, and if it continues like that, it will definitely collapse. One of the most important facts that you have to accept, and that may not be on the surface if you are lucky to live in a normal democratic countries all of your life, that authoritarian regimes like Russia, China or the North Korea, they never share true information in their media, on their TV, and their population actually knows nothing about the state of the country. We know in our countries because we are typically very critical to our politicians, decision makers. We have access to the information, we can analyze it, but in Russia everything is filtered, everything is censored, and people simply listen to what their ruler says. And Putin says everything is fine, when actually with each day Russian economy resembles the Soviet economy more and more. And we all know that the main reason why actually the USSR collapsed was its economic troubles. Hopefully this will work out this time too. So anyway, what is happening right now? Russia had to reshape its trading patterns. It has great troubles with export. For example, Ukrainian strategy to set their oil refineries on fire works really well, and I think it's actually one of the best solutions that we have come up with. And not that many trade partners, not that many opportunities to cooperate with banks, stocks and so on. So they are trying to keep this economy alive with lots and lots and lots of state dotations. It's obvious that Russian economy is now a military economy, and lots of frozen military plants and factories are now working 3-4 shifts with lots of people getting new jobs. But no, this is not good, because these are not like real organic companies developing. These are all state-funded enterprises that do not even produce good missiles, because you know they are in a hurry and every second missile targets Russian land instead of Ukrainian, or maybe that's the way karma works. But these are not just like examples of economy developing, businesses growing. These are state-funded bloody enterprises. And what is more important, they actually lack people to work in the military industry, and they are seriously considering changing prisons to forced labor options. So can you imagine? It brings us back to the times of Stalin, to the plots like in Orwell's books. They want forced labor workers to produce these tanks and missiles. Of course, I can just imagine their quality, attitudes, and perhaps they will start imprisoning more and more people in Russia to get more and more free workers. So this is an example of Sovietization of their economy, and actually one of the most dangerous and one of the most dark. Also, expropriation. Expropriation was a trouble at the very start of the Soviet Union and was one of the reasons for the genocide Holodomor in Ukraine, because we had a strong middle class, rich peasants who did not want to join collective farms and other evil communist expropriation is just taking away your property, and there are signals that similar things are happening with small, middle-sized businesses inside Russia, especially the ones that do not support Putin's special military operation on the destruction of the Russian Federation, actually. And perhaps more and more people will be dissatisfied with that, because come on, not everyone wants to work on a tank plant. And something, once again, that will be very difficult to understand for people coming from normal democratic countries is that they literally never pay much attention to the social and economic well-being of the population. It has never been the priority of Russia. You may not believe and think that I'm very subjective, but the state treats its population in Russia, in Soviet Union, it was the same as slaves, as serfs. And that might be actually one of the reasons why Russian soldiers are that filled with hatred, especially when they witness Ukrainian lifestyle, that our ordinary people, our ordinary middle class lives much better than the majority of Russia. So anyway, they totally do not care about the quality of life, about, I don't know, healthcare, about the way your streets look, your roads look, whether you have toilets in your apartment building or not. And that's why they simply do not spend perhaps a very big part of the budget that in any other country is spent on this well-being at all in general. And of course, they are trying to look for various loops to escape sanctions. For example, the famous Russia's Shadow Fleet. By the way, I have never spoken about that on the channel. Let me know in the comments below, would you like a separate video about that? Because I feel that's an important topic. We know that ruble is like collapsing and inflation is very serious in Russia. They have serious troubles with the prices on petrol, oil and gas. And this is actually one of the main industries inside the Federation, or was one of the main industries until we started targeting their refineries. And they have also banned the export of oil products, which is huge. So we prevent them from fueling their tanks and also from fueling their military machine. What is also important, and I'm sure many people understand, that right now the Chinese economy is in a serious decline, and partially because of their close cooperation with Russia. And I believe that being extremely pragmatic, at a certain moment of time, China will understand that backing up Russia is a problem for them. I don't trust China as a country that can make humane decisions. Personally, I do not support Ukraine trying to persuade China work with Russia for negotiations, ceasefire, and so on. But I believe in this pragmatic, very bad side of China that may realize that friendship with Russia is actually bad for them. What is also important to understand that Russian military economy is not only about the construction of tanks, the construction of missiles and submarines, it's also about the information war. And according to the intelligence services of our Western partners, we know that approximately per year they spend $1.5 billion on informational warfare. That's why subscribe to my channel to back up Ukraine. We don't spend money on information warfare. And please share the videos on all the social platforms that you feel like sharing, because once again, we are not an authoritarian regime here, but I am always grateful if more people can learn about Ukraine, our resilience, and also if more people can be warned about the dangers of Russia. Imagine $1.5 billion per year to lie to all of us, to manipulate our opinion, to try to change your thoughts on some important core issues, to undermine your values. Because at this moment, Russia is pure evil, and it is our task to defeat the Kremlin and to de-zombify the people, but it will take decades and perhaps billions of dollars. So anyway, join me on Instagram, Threads, X, and Discord to see more of everyday life in Ukraine. I share some other stuff there. Also check our merch shop. There are lots of good items and a new summer drop. They all work well as reminders and conversation starters about Ukraine. Thank you for buying me coffees, becoming my patrons and sponsors of the channel, and helping me film and write more. And thank you for all the conversations that you hold inside your countries to debunk Russian lies and to support Ukraine. Slava Ukraini!